So today we are going to discuss with the special features in Oracle. Earlier it was not there, and that particular feature that we are going to discuss is called flashback. So first of all, what exactly the flashback is? Suppose we are having a table, and what we can do, we can drop the table, and again after dropping the table, suppose I want to get the table back. How we can do that? One option was there, if we are having the data in the backup, we can recover the data from the backup. But suppose we don't have the data in the backup, then what we need to do? For that purpose, what we can do, we can use the flashback. So basically, flashback is the new feature. It's not the new feature, like right now we are talking about the Oracle 18c. It's not the 18c, it was introduced in Oracle 10g. So it was the feature of Oracle 10g, but still it's considered the new feature. So what exactly the flashback is? See, in Oracle we can do the two things. One is, what we can do, we can flashback the table, we can get the table back. And that was the feature introduced in Oracle 10g. And one option is also there, what we can do, we can flashback the data. Even you can flashback the data, and that this was the feature introduced in Oracle 9i. But still, these are the new feature that people are going to consider it as a new feature, because normally it's, people are not familiar with all these concepts. So there is the option called flashback. Flashback means what? We can recover the table even after the drop. That is flashback the table. And again, we are having the flashback the data. Even you can recover the data also. Suppose we are having a table. In the EMP table, we are having some records over there. And I am going to delete the record. And after the delete, I am going to apply the commit. Remember, after the delete, I am going to apply the commit. So all the data will get removed from there. It will be permanent, but I want to recover the data, then how we can do that? That is called flashback the data and flashback the table. So we are having a two option is there. One is flashback table and one is flashback data. So how we can do this flashback data and flashback table? First of all, I'm going to discuss with the flashback data. Flashback data. See, in Oracle we are having the concept of query. Query is basically going to return the current data. And in Oracle we are having also the concept of flashback query. Flashback query is going to return the previous data. It's going to return the previous data. So we are having the two concepts over there. It's queries and it's flashback queries. Flashback query is going to return us the previous data. If I want to get the previous data, what we can do, we can apply the flashback query. Suppose I am going to write, this is the table we are having, select star from EMP. These are the tables, 16 records are there. What I am going to do, I am going to delete that, delete from EMP. Now, the 16 rows deleted. Now what I am going to do, I am just going to make it commit. Now, if after the commit, if I am going to apply the select star from EMP, we don't have anything and already it's committed. Now what we need to do, we need to flashback the data. Or I want to see the previous data before the commit, how was the table and all. So I want to see that. So how we can do that? For that purpose, we just need to write the flashback query. And how we can write the flashback query? I'm just going to write select star from EMP, and we need to use the keyword as of, and we need to specify the time. So I'm just going to use timestamp. And what we need to see? We need to see the data 2 minutes back or 1 minute back. So I'm just going to write sysdate minus interval. And how many minutes you are looking for? I want to get the data 5 minutes back. So I'm just going to give like 5 minutes. I'm just going to write 5 minutes. See, this was the data. 5 minutes back, before the commit, this was the data over there. So this is what, this is called flashback query. I'm writing select star from EMP as of timestamp. We just need to give the timestamp, and we need to give the interval. So I'm just going to give sysdate minus interval, and I want to get the data 5 minutes back, or 10 minutes back, or 15 minutes back. We can write over here. So I'm writing sysdate minus interval and 5 minutes, and we are getting all data. So what we can do now? I want to insert the same data over there in the EMP table as well. So what we can do now? I'm just going to write insert into EMP. And again I am going to apply, yeah, see, all the previous data get back into the EMP table, select star from EMP. So this is what, this is called flashback query. Flashback query means the query it was earlier like. This is called flashback data, and the query that we are writing is known as flashback query. It's clear? For the flashback query, you need to write the command like this. I am writing select star from EMP as of timestamp, and we are writing sysdate minus interval, and we just need to give the time like 5 or 10 or 15, whatever, and we are just writing the minute over there, and we are getting this. So this is what, this is called flashback data. Now, after the flashback data, the next thing is we are having, it's called flashback table. Flashback table. What exactly the flashback table is? Suppose I'm going to drop the table. Drop table EMP. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to drop the table. Drop table EMP. Yeah, table get dropped. If I'm going to write select star from EMP, nothing is there. But remember, internally Oracle maintain the recycle bin. Internally Oracle maintain the recycle bin. Whenever we are going to create any, we are going to drop any table, all the data will go into the recycle bin. We can check it out, like I am writing so recycle bin. If I am going to write the command so recycle bin, it will display the previous data. Right now the problem is I am using Oracle 11g with my system. In your system it's Oracle 18c is there, so it will work properly. In 11g I need to put some different approach over there. I will show you what the approach I need to follow, but in your system, like you are having Oracle 18c is there, so you can do it right directly, like drop table, the name of the table. No, nothing is there. If I'm going to use so recycle bin, you will get the details of that. Now, what I want to do, I want to recover the data from the recycle bin, because the data will be available with the recycle bin. So what I want to do, I want to recover the data. So what we can write over here, we can write flashback. We can write the command flashback over there, flashback table EMP. That was the name of the table I'm going to write, and we just need to use two before drop. Now I am getting the message object not in recycle bin, because I am using Oracle 11g over there. In 11g it's a different approach that I need to follow. So this is the approach that I am going to follow with the Oracle 11g. For this, what we need to understand, we need to understand few new things over there. See, the entire Oracle is based on the database. I will discuss about the database, what are the architectures of the database and all. And this database is consist of table spaces. Database is consist of table spaces. And this particular table spaces is going to link with the data file. whatever the table you are going to create, that table is going to associate with the individual table spaces, and every table space is linked with the data file. Every table spaces get linked with the data file. I am just going to show you how to create the table space, because I just need to give the demonstration of the flashback table. So what I am going to do, I am going to create a table space. By default, the table space is system. On the system table space in Oracle 11g, you can't do this. So what I am going to do, I am going to create a separate table space over there. So I am just going to write connect slash as sysdba, and I am going to create a table space. Create table space, table space. The name of the table space I am going to give, and I am just going to mention the data file. The data file will be there in the E drive by the name of data1.dbf, and I am just going to mention the size. The size will be like 1 MB or 10 MB. So this is how you can create the table space. Now what I can do, I am just going to connect with the Scott Tiger. Now I am going to create a table. I am going to create a table, create table, and suppose my table is EMP. I am going to create like employee number is of type number of 4. Again, I am going to use employee name is of type varchar 2 of 20, and I am going to put the salary over there. Salary is of type number of 4. Now what I am going to do, I am going to insert the value. Oh, drop this, drop table EMP. Once again, I am going to create the table. At last, I am going to mention the table space. Table space, what table space it's going to associate? It's going to associate the Santosh table space. Means under this particular table, if I am going to insert the value, all the value will get stored in the E drive. The name of the data, yeah, this is the physical location of your data. Whatever the data you are going to put over here, it will get stored in this location, data1.dbf, because data1.dbf is the name of the file that's associated with the table space Santosh, and my table is going to store the value in this particular data file, table space only. So this is how we can create the table space, and this is how we can associate the table with the table space. Now I am going to insert the value, insert into EMP. Values I am going to give, employee number 1, employee name is this one, and salary I am going to give like this. Again I am going to put the another values over there. Again I am going to put the another values over there. Again I am going to put the another value over there. Again I am going to put the another values over there. And finally I am going to make it commit. Yeah, select a star from EMP. Yeah, now what I am going to do, I am going to drop the table. Drop table EMP. Yeah, table get dropped. Now I am going to apply show recycle bin. The same steps I am going to follow. Yeah, my EMP table is there in the recycle bin by the name of this. Remember, like Windows, like Linux, Oracle is going to maintain the recycle bin. Even after the drop the table, the data will be there in the recycle bin, and my data is there in the recycle bin. What I can do, even from the recycle bin I can get the data also. I can select the data, select star from the recycle bin I am going to give. I am just going to make it copy. This is the name of table itself. It's a recycle bin name, it's a temporary name I am going to give. I am going to mention over there. See, we are getting the data. I am writing select star from the name from the recycle bin, and we are getting the data. Now what I want to do, so my data is there in the recycle bin. So what I want to do, I want to recover the data. So how we can recover the data? For that we just need to write down the command flashback. So I am just going to write down the command flashback over there, flashback table EMP to before drop. Flashback get completed. Now if I am going to write down the command, you see the data is there. So even after the drop, you can flashback the table. This is called flashback table. Even after the commit, you can recover the data, previous data, that is called flashback. data. So you can recover the data, you can recover the table. For that purpose, we are having the command called flashback. I am writing flashback table, the name of the table to before drop. Now, suppose I am going to drop the table emp, and what I want to do, like now, it get dropped. If I am going to show the recycle bin, so recycle bin, this data is there. I want to remove it permanently. So how we can do that? If I want to remove it permanently, for that purpose we are having the command, and that particular command is known as the purge command is there. So what we can do, we can write purge table emp. The data will get removed permanently. Now the recycle bin is blank. After the purge, you cannot recover the data from the recycle bin, because purge is just like remove the data from the recycle bin. Now, one important thing, suppose once again I am going to create the table. Create table. Once again I am going to insert the values. Now, if I am going to apply drop table emp, then naturally the table will get stored in the recycle bin after the drop. The recycle bin is going to maintain that, but I don't want to send it to the recycle bin. I want to make it permanent. So what we can do, we can apply the purge command over there. Purge. Now, if I am going to see, so recycle bin, nothing is there. So this was really the good concept. Remember, this was really the good concept. This is known as flashback. Flashback means what? Number one, you can recover the data. And this concept was introduced in Oracle, in Oracle 9i. And the next concept is what we can do? We can recover the table. Recover the table means what? After the drop, you can recover the table. And this concept was get introduced in Oracle 10g. So this is all about the flashback. Flashback means what? You can get the data, even you can get the